Chapter 9. "Who is that?" asked Ed Crosswire. The rest of the crowd was silent. "Answer the question," said the voice. "Have you read the book you're condemning?" The crowd pulled back to start rebuffing the speaker. Archer recognized her. She was the woman he had spoke with in the park. Mr. Crosswire cleared his throat. "I'm proud to say that I wouldn't read this book if you paid me," the woman signed. "I'm not surprised," she said. Mr. Crosswire looked steadily. "Why, I know you. You're Miss McGall, my grad school English teacher." "Yes, I am, Edward," she walked up the steps. "I'm glad to see your memory has failed you, even if your common sense has. Miss McGall, I assure you, I have every bit as much common sense as I ever did." She stood beside him. "That may be true," she admitted. "I see you haven't changed. You never were much of a reader. Can you appreciate how hard a writer work to create stories kids will like to read? His story is like a seed, Edward. If a child read one, the seed may grow into the desire to read another. That sometimes every writer hopes for." Mr. Crosswire curled his arm. "Oh, really, Miss McGall? Your century are fine teacher. But what makes you such an expert about what writers hope for?" "Well, I'm a writer myself." "Oh, I'm sure we are delighted to hear that, Miss McGall," hesitated. "Anything we know?" Miss McGall stayed Mr. Crosswire's jacket and felt something from his shoulder. "Nothing you read, Edward, condemning your common sense or sense all in all. But sign you ask, I'm the author of the Scare Your Pants Up Club book." "You," said Mr. Crosswire, turning pale. He had sudden vision of Miss McGall walking him down to the principal office. "You," said Arthur. "Her," Francine, Buster, Sue Ellen, and the brain said together. The woman nodded. "E.A.D. Poe is my pen name," Muffin newly explored with excitement. "Missy Poe," she cried, "I'm your number one fan. I have all your books. Could I have your—" Her parents glared at her. "Oops!" She clasped her hand across her mouth as her parents grounded her. "You read them all?" said her father. "And just when did you do that?" asked her mother. "Mary always Crosswire. You got some fancy play to do." "Uh-oh," said Muffy. "If you read all of this book," said Mrs. Crosswire, "the obvious it was one of them that gave you the nightmare." "What was it?" "Where?" Muffy hated it when her mother sounded like a detective. "Just a minute here," said Mr. Crosswire. He stared at Muffy. "No. Now I know who ate my quart of handsome perfect ice cream and then had afraid to admit it," said her mother. "Mary Alice, you know eating like that give you bad dream." "Well, very disappointed in you," said her father. "And I'm disappointed in you too," Muffy's mother said her husband. "What were you doing with a quart of that ice cream anyway?" "Well, Arthur almost smiled. Muffy and her father were both standing with their heads hanging low. They looked very much alike. Miss McGall cleared her throat. "I hate to interrupt a promising family squabble, but we've still got some business to settle. Edward, maybe you can take your foot out of your mouth long enough to listen to one of my stories. That what you can make is an informed decision about how shouldn't be reading them. Oh, yes, excellent idea. At this particular moment, anything was better than facing his wife.